Hello students, this is Dr. Anita Raj, your chemistry mentor, welcoming you for a new session in solid state. Today we shall see what is a crystal lattice and a unit cell and the different types of unit cells in detail. Okay, first let us see what is a crystal lattice. See, this crystal lattice is otherwise called as a space lattice. Okay, so actually it is the three-dimensional arrangement of constituent particles in a crystal. Okay, what are the constituent particles? See, it may be atoms or molecules or ions. See, these atoms or molecules or ions, it may be arranged in three-dimensional pattern in a crystal, and that is called as a crystal lattice or a crystal space. See here, these points are called as, these points are the constituent particles, like main atoms or ions or molecules. Okay, and in fact this crystal lattice is in fact an array of points. Okay, it's an array of points, right? So next one is lattice points or lattice sites. What do you mean by lattice points or lattice sites? See, in a crystal lattice, the locations of the structural units or the constitutional particles. What do you mean by constitutional particles? As I told you, they are the atoms or ions or molecules, okay? And they are shown by points, okay? Those points are called as crystal lattice points or lattice sites, okay? So, in a crystal lattice, the locations of the structural units, that is atoms or ions or molecules, are shown by points, okay? See here, these points are called as the lattice points or the lattice sites, okay? Next important thing is the characters of this crystal lattice or the space lattice. So, I have given a crystal lattice, and we shall see the characteristic features of this crystal lattice one by one. The first point is, each point in the space lattice represents the position of a constituent particle of the crystal. As I told you earlier, in the crystal lattice, each point represents the constituent particles. Constituent particles means atoms or ions or molecules. So that's repeated again. So each point in the space lattice, each point in the space lattice represents the position of a constituent particle of the crystal. Okay. But what comes the next? Each point in the space lattice has the same environment as that of any other point in the lattice. Taking into account this point, it is surrounded by the same type of constituent particles, and when you are taking into consideration the next one, it will be also having the same environment. It will be surrounded by the same environment, okay, that's given in this point, right? So the third point goes like this. The whole space lattice is actually a three-dimensional repetition of a small 3D group of lattice points called unit cell. See here, the whole structure, that is the whole space lattice, is actually a three-dimensional repetition of a small 3D group of lattice points. See, this is the 3D group of lattice points. Okay, this is the 3D group of lattice points, and it is called as the unit cell. And this unit cell will be continuously getting repeated. See here, this is one unit cell, and this is the next unit cell. So this whole space lattice or the crystal lattice will be having the repetition of this unit cells. Okay, so this unit cell will be a 3D arrangement of lattice points. Okay, so this is called as the unit cell, and this unit cell will be getting repeated in this crystal lattice. Okay, so the crystal lattice is formed by the repeated formation or repeated arrangement of this 3D group of lattice points called as the unit cell. Understood? Now let us see what is a unit cell. As I told you, that is the smallest repeating unit, that is the smallest 3D arrangement of lattice points. Okay, this 3D arrangement of lattice points will be getting repeated over and over again in a crystal lattice. Understood? So the smallest repeating unit in a space lattice, which when repeated over and over again, results in the crystal of the given substance. Whatever may be the given substance, the unit cell will be getting repeated over and over again. So this unit cell will be a 3D arrangement of lattice points. Understood? So it is the miniature, it is the smallest repeating unit. Okay, so the unit cell is the smallest repeating unit in a space lattice, which when repeated over and over again, results in a crystals of the of the given substance. Okay, so this points, as you know, this is called as the lattice points. Okay, and this is the unit cell. Understood, students? Next we are going to see what are the parameters of a unit cell. Okay, See, actually there are two parameters. One is the axial distance and next one is the axial angle. So before knowing this axial distance, what is the axial distance or what this axial angle is, you should know two important points. One is corner, okay, one is corner and another one is edge, okay, edge, and the next important term is face, okay. So let me show what is a corner here. See, this is the unit cell, okay, this is the unit cell, that is the smallest repeating unit of a space lattice, all right. Okay, so this is the corner, okay, this is the corner of the unit cell, okay, this is the corner of the unit cell. And next one is edge. What is edge? This is the distance between these two corners, okay, this is the edge, this is called as the edge, understood? So these are called as the edges, okay. What is face then? Face is this one, this is the face, okay, this one is face and this is face, and here also this is a face and this is a face and this is a face, okay. So corners, edges and faces. Now we shall see what is an axial distance. They see the relative length of ABC of the three edges, okay. See here, this is this distance between these two, A and B and C, okay. This relative length is called as the axial distance, okay. That axial angle is, what is axial angle? Angles with alpha, this is alpha, that is the angle between B and C. Angle between A and C is beta. Angle between B and A is gamma, okay. So the angle between the edges, the angles between the edges, that is alpha, beta, gamma. What are the edges? BC, between BC, between AC and AB are called as the axial angles, okay. So these two are very important for doing problems, okay. Axial distances and axial angles. Understood, students? Next, we shall move on to the different types of unit cells, okay. First, there are two different types of unit cells, that is primitive unit cell and non-primitive unit cell, okay. So what is a primitive unit cell? See, this type of unit cells in which the constituent particles are present only at its corners is called as primitive unit cell. This primitive unit cell is also otherwise called as a basic unit cell or simple unit cell, okay. See here, the constituent, we can see the constituent particles only at the corners, okay. So these are the corners, right. So the constituent particles, that is atoms or ions or the molecules, will be present only at the corners in primitive unit cell, okay. So this is another format. See here, this is a cube, right, this is a unit cell, and here we could see the constituent particles at the corners, only at the corners we could see the constituent particles. So this is an example of primitive unit cell, okay. So what is non-primitive unit cell? See, non-primitive unit cell is unlike this primitive unit cell. It contains additional lattice points either on the face or within the unit cell. Either on the face, see, these are the faces. It's not either we could see the constituent particles or lattice points on the faces or inside the unit cell along with the corners. Okay, along with the corners, right? So those unit cells are called as non-primitive unit cells. In non-primitive unit cells, we are having three types. Face-centered unit cell, body-centered unit cell and edge-centered unit cell. We shall see one by one now. So what is face-centered unit cell? See, in this unit cell in which the constituent particles are present at the center of each faces, okay, we could see the constituent particles at the center. This is one face, is it not? So here we can see, and in this face you can see, here also we can see, here, okay, and again here in this face and in this face, okay. So, for totally, how many faces are there? Six faces, is it not? Six faces, right? So, along with the corner particles, along with the particles on the corners, we could see the particles in the on the faces also, okay? See here in the corners also, we could see the particles and along the faces also, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and at the back, we'll be having 6, okay? See here in this, it's clearly shown, along with the corner particles, along with the corner particles, we could see the constituent particles on the faces, here in this face, and again in this face we are having, here at the above we are having, here also we are having, and here in the front side we are also here, okay. So, the unit cells in which the constituent particles are present at the center of each face in addition to the particles at its corners is called as a face-centered unit cell. Understood? What do you mean by body-centered unit cell? Okay, the next one is body-centered unit cell. What do you mean by body-centered unit cell? The unit cell in which one constituent particle is present at the center in addition to the particles at its corner is called as body center. Okay, along the along with the particles in the corners, we can see one particle at the center. Okay, one particle will be seen at the center, body center. So we call this type of unit cell as body centered unit cell. Okay, see here, along with the corners, here in the corners we are having constant particles, and again we are having one particle at the center, so we call this as a body center. In this it is clearly shown, the particles are seen in the corners, okay, and then again there is only one particle inside the unit cell, so we call this type as body centered unit cell. Okay, the last one is the N centered unit cell. What is N centered unit cell? The unit cell in which the constituent particles on two opposite faces, you can see constituent particles on two opposite, either in this or in this or here and at the back. Okay, so either in two opposite faces of the cube, in addition to the particles at its corner, is called as the N centered. Okay, see here, it is clearly shown here. We could see the particle in opposite faces, two particles in opposite faces along with the particles in the corners. Okay, so this is here also, it's clearly shown, particles are seen at the corners, right, and at the middle of opposite faces. Okay, so this is called as N centered unit cell. Well, fine students, you might have got a clear cut idea about the crystal lattice, unit cell and its types. I shall meet you with another important topic in a short period. Until then, it's Dr. Anita signing off from you. Thanks for watching.